I'm Jackson Pierce, and this video is about the zombie apocalypse. I have to confess something, I am not really a doomsday kind of girl. I usually assume that situations will work out for the best, and for the most part, that's kind of suited me. I didn't panic over Y2K, and I'm not super concerned about 2012, despite Hollywood's best attempts to freak me out. However, while I'm not exactly, you know, stocking up on canned goods or buying firearms right and left, I do give disasters a second thought from time to time. And given the fact that they're filming that show, The Walking Dead, like literally footsteps from my door, I've been thinking about zombies a lot recently. And thus, I have formulated a plan for the zombie apocalypse, and I will share it with you now. Step 1. When I've heard rumors of a zombie outbreak, I'm not gonna waste any time. So while the rest of the Bible Belt is making those placards that say repent now, I'm gonna be stocking up on fuel, thank you very much. See, a major flaw in most people's zombie plan is they try to fortify a single place, like a house or a town. But if the zombie horde surrounds that house or town or whatever it is, and you don't have a way of getting supplies in, then that's pretty much it for you. Instead of trying to fortify a single place, I'm going to go on to step 2 of my plan, which is to buy the largest Airstream trailer my credit limit will allow, because let's face it, after the zombie apocalypse, I'm not paying off my credit cards. I'm not. Or hey, if the Airstream dealership owner has been zombified, I'll just steal one, you know? After the zombie apocalypse, my concerns over my credit score and the most wanted list has kind of diminished, so yeah, I'll steal a trailer. So anyway, Grand Theft Auto aside, I'm gonna start driving. I'll pick up some friends and family, I'll stop and stock up on, you know, food items and fuel, but I'm gonna keep driving for the most part. Which incidentally is step 3, keep driving. If a place seems relatively zombie-free, sure, I'll stay for a while, provided I've got an automatic weapon. But my trailer is gonna be ready to go at the first sign of an oncoming zombie horde. So, step 4 is make it to the coast. I've never manned a boat before, so I'm gonna hope somebody left a, you know, how-to manual lying around, but I'm gonna trade in my Airstream for the biggest boat at the dock, like one of those yachts that Paris Hilton rides around on, the kind you can really live out of. At this point, I have two options, which I like to call step 5A and step 5B. Step 5A is to stay on my sweet boat that I just stole, and hopefully it will stay zombie-free. Step 5B is to find some kind of island where I can go all Gilligan and live on coconuts with a hot professor and, you know, that kind of thing. As long as there are no zombies on the island, in theory, no zombies will be able to get to the island. See, the thing about the zombie apocalypse is I'm a writer. I'm not gonna be able to solve the zombie problem. I could barely pass high school biology. So in the events of a zombie apocalypse, the best I can hope for is survival. And I think that's why I and so many others kind of have plans in our head for the ultimate disaster, even though realistically, no matter how much you prepare for these kind of things, you can't really prepare for these kind of things. Because having a plan, even if it's useless, it kind of makes us feel like we're in control. Makes us feel like as hellish as the world may get, we'll still be in the driver's seat. And that driver's seat is behind the wheel of a 2011 28-foot Airstream International trailer. Yeah. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you on Thursday.